spot. The case for Lindale School to remain open comes not simply from the head, but also from the heart. The arguments put forward for closure are far from sound and stand bankrupt of reason. Let's now look to end the anxiety and uncertainty we have truly burdened parents and staff of this very special school with for far too long. Let's get on with the job of ensuring that children with such profound disabilities have an education which takes into account the true cost of meeting their needs, with a funding formula reflective of our desire to allow a school like Lindale to thrive. And let's begin by passing this motion this evening.
I was very concerned that if this motion was passed, to be honest, would fall foul of predetermination. I think it's a shame, actually, that Councillor Hayes, he actually said officers were not neutral. I mean, you know, I was cabinet member for education for 9 years and went through a number of these school closures, and it's always very, very painful and very difficult. And all of them have been, heart-rending. But to claim that the officers are not neutral, I think is really disingenuous. In all my years of working in the council, and particularly on these issues, officers are scrupulously fair and objective. And I do think it's a shame that, that you made that comment. But nevertheless, the amendment merely, Mr. Mayor, asks that we take no action on this motion tonight. It doesn't say we either support it or don't support it. We simply refer it together with all the other evidence, and I too received the report from the parents of Wirral over the weekend. So that needs to be considered as well. But I really worry that if we take if we agree this motion tonight, we will have predetermined the outcome of this issue before we have considered all the evidence. And what I've said consistently, Mr. Mayor, throughout this whole debate is, yes, I mean, there's no question that Lindale does provide a unique and caring environment. And I too visited the school to see the work that goes on there. It's fantastic work. But I think it is absolutely essential that we keep an open mind. We consider all the evidence. And I'm therefore moving our amendment to say, let's do just that. Let's refer this motion. Let's look, at the very least, we need to consider the outcome of the consultation, and then hopefully we can reach an informed decision. But I really do worry to them that by passing this tonight, we will have basically completely ignored all that informed evidence that is in the consultation report, which I reiterate, I have not yet seen. So I'll leave it at that, and I'll move that now. Thank you, Mr. Mayor.
Okay, it's open for the debate, and the conscience of the first.
Thank you, Mr. Mayor. I do not want to talk about facts and figures for supporting, that's why we're here this evening, to discuss the future of their schools. I have a daughter with learning difficulties, much you've met her, Sophie, a young woman, about 30 years of age. But unfortunately, she has a mental age of 9, and will remain like that for the rest of the remainder of her life. Despite that, however, I consider myself lucky, because not only is she a beautiful young woman, she does have her full health. And unfortunately for the parents and pupils in their school, they do have complicated health issues, and they do need constant specialist care. Going back to my daughter Sophie, I'm content that she now lives in an establishment that caters for her needs whilst giving her the independence she requires and deserves. That place is Lee Court. You know how much. You were there at the opening a few years ago. It is one less worry for me that she lives in a suitable, safe surroundings, and I can understand the parents and pupils of Lindale School and their desire to fight and keep this establishment open, because Lindale School does fit the bill when talking about Wirral's corporate plan. Wirral will be a place where the vulnerable are safe and protected, and where good health and an excellent quality of life is within reach of everyone who lives there. This is what Lindale School is all about, and the parents and the pupils attending the school can be assured and rest easy that Lindale is a centre of specialised educational and medical expertise, and it is an essential service that meets their children's complex needs. Whilst attending the school, whatever the pupils' complex needs are, the staff and the establishment are geared up to meeting those needs and ensure that whilst receiving education, the pupils are safe and well cared for. I read through the document that was mentioned by the Mayor before, which was delivered to my home, and referring to page 5, paragraph 110, I was also perplexed that the parents, as the parents were, with regards to the decision to close the school, or it's closed school. As one of the policy has said, the council will not benefit financially from Lindale closure. Why do it then? Why take away the brings much value and needed school. Its contributions are invaluable, and the pupils prefer to third. To close it down, or if we close it down, whoever makes the decision, they'll have to think carefully about how they vote. The pupils who attend them there, unlike us here in this chamber, do not have the best starts in life. We can do something with regards to that, to assist them to make their lives more secure and comfortable. Let's not let them down. Keep the school open.
Time over the weekend to read the documents supplied